Okay, so first shots from Century Arms VSKA, brand new production. Just went down the pipe. I'm checking the sights from 100 meters distance. Of course, the rear slider is at 100. And I will tell you right away that we are a little bit low. I was aiming at the plate and the shots went to the small hanging plates. So that shouldn't happen. I will raise the post. So let me see how I'll raise the point of impact, not the post. So of course I'm twisting in. Well, I'll go two turns. We'll see what's going to happen. And this is the trusted tool, which we have, by the way, in our store. If you have stubborn front post or that drum on iron sights on AK, this is the best tool to use. So just the hint. As you guys can see, this is before we even do any videos. I just want to get the feeling of the rifle, make sure the iron sights are on target, and basically that rifle is working. So let me go back behind the gun and let's try to put it on that target. Hey, that was a miss. Yeah, we are outside the target. So now I know that I was hitting the one of the plates underneath of the target. Let me see, I'll go to left. Okay, that's a miss. Let me go to right. Nothing. I'll go higher. Alright. And let me check where that hit was. My trusted Leopold scope. There we go. Okay, so we are on the in the middle, more on the right side, but a little bit low. But I was aiming at the head. And so we are still way too low. We have to correct that. So we need more. Let's see if this will make an impact. Again, as you can see, slow work. No time to rush at anything. Take your time when zeroing gun. I got the hit. Got the hit. That's a hit. Let me again check where we are. I was aiming at the middle of the plate. Okay. And we are in the middle of the plate. That's a nice group growing there, by the way. I'm a little bit on the right side of the plate, so I will slightly move the front post to the right and we'll see how we're going to do now. So again, because I'm hitting the plate on the right side, I'm going to push the drum to the right side. And watch out when you're doing it, if you got the rod in the chamber, just like I do, don't cover the muzzle. Okay, a slight push, not much, because we were just a little bit. And let's see if this is going to be it. Okay, again, I'm going to use the scope, and it looks like we may be a little bit too much on the left now. So this is what happens. That's okay.
That's surprising. I got the shell here. I didn't look at the ejection pattern, but as you can see, oh, check this out, guys. The shells are very close to the rifle. This is maybe 2 feet away. Ola, are all of them went so close? Are we bouncing off from something?
I didn't pay attention.
That is rather weak ejection pattern. Yeah, the shells are right here. That's kind of surprising. But very soft recoil, guys. Of course, I got BD2 from Meridian Defense on it, but it's a very soft recoil. Okay, let me just stop it. Okay, that should do it. And we'll leave it as this. Now let's see if we can take some shots. And out. So there you go. Confirmation from the kneeling position worked out just great. I just want to show you guys short video what's happening before we even go and start doing the videos. So there is some work. I'm always making sure that the rifle is lubricated, like that Century Arms VSKA was completely dry when I got it, so I lubricated and cleaned the barrel. And we're checking the iron sights. So 100 meters mark, we are at the 100 meters and the rifle is zeroed and ready for fun with the episodes and watch for the 5,000 rounds test. You already see what's happening. We have surprisingly rather short ejection pattern from what I'm seeing. Rifle was here. Ula, if you could do the shot where the shells, majority of the shells are here. So I don't know, I will have to check the video if the shots were bouncing from something or not. But that's rather surprising to see to see the ejection pattern like this from AK. Usually it's a good 14, 16, 17 feet away. So this is no more than 2 feet from the position where I was shooting. Very soft recoil, I said that, and the rifle will be accurate, guys. I will tell you right away, the rifle should be grouping very nicely, but that was always the case with the Century Arms rifles. That's not our worry. After zeroing rifle, I like to check what the rifle can do from the different distances. Again, this is a regular standard procedure. So I'll shoot from 100 meters right now from standing position and move to 200 and 300. We'll see how this will do. We got some nasty wind today, but hey, it is what it is. Everything for you guys, right? Okay, so we managed to score 3 double hits on 3 different targets from 100 meters. That's almost 110 yards from standing position. I'll see what this rifle can do right now from 200. So let's go. So the mother nature a little bit destroyed our plans. As you guys can see, we had the visitors. You have to remember, this is the livestock farm. So the cows, they always have a right way. But we used that time to repaint the targets and reset the camera. All good, we'll see. We are way past 200 yards right now. I got the mark on the 200 meters. We are below 200 meters, a few yards shy from the 200 meters. But I will try to aim a little bit low and we'll see how those rounds are going to place from kneeling position on those 3 steel ups targets. Hopefully we'll register some hits. As I said, we got some wind downrange, but it's not that bad. We'll see what we can do. That was the hit. And that was the hit. That was the hit. And that was out. Look at that, guys. The magazine didn't feed. Oh, there is a round in the chamber, actually. And the firing pin went off. Okay. Well, that's unexpected. All right, let me remove the round. The firing pin shot, guys. So we'll wait a few seconds. Yep, and I see the primer was pierced on that round. So this is just the faulty ammo. We'll wait a few seconds to make sure the round won't cook off outside the chamber. So I'm using a Target Golden Tiger ammo, guys. So there's nothing special about this ammo, but that's the first dot I have. And as you can see, check it out, Ulau, pointed like this. See, clearly the primer was pierced, but nothing happened. There you go, guys, live TV. What can I say? The stuff is happening, but this one is not on the Century. This is just the bad ammo. All right, let me go back to shooting. So if I remember that correctly, I owe you guys one more hit on that middle target. Let's see if we can manage to accomplish this mission. Yep, there you go. All right. So as you can see, we connected six times with some little hiccup with basically bad primer, I would say, at this point on the Golden Tiger ammo. But we connected six times with the target's downrange from almost 200 meters, way past 200 yards. So far so good. Past 300 yards, way past 300 yards, but shy from 300 meters again. Slider is at 300 meters. I had to move to that position where I'm on the slab because the AK shoots with a rainbow trajectory, and I don't want to damage the fence. We have like a portion of the fence there. So I moved away from that fence. Hopefully we're going to score some hits. Again, the wind is back, guys. I didn't reset the targets. We got some hits on the targets from 200. So we'll see and we'll compare how this is going to register. Of course, you know already, because you have seen the video footage from the target. I haven't seen that footage yet, but that's fine. We'll see. We'll roll with it. All right, let me, yeah, see how everything is under the angle. That could be difficult, but I'll try to do my best here. Yeah, the whole tank is just sliding. That's not really stable position, but it's okay. I'll aim in the middle of the target, we'll see. I think these were two hits. You cannot really hear the steel very good right now. That was a hit for sure. Last target. That was a hit. That was a hit. All right, so we got some hits. I'm not sure about the first target. I didn't have a good hearing, but we connected for sure with some of the steel. So if we don't have all the hits, then the mission accomplished, sort of George W. Bush way, right? But we did connect it from best way 300 yards. And so far so good. So this is what I do, guys. I just want to do that short video. I think it's not short anymore. Ula told me that we are way past like 30 minutes, but you can see even before going into the regular videos and starting doing the magazine dumps and everything. This is what I do to get the feeling of the rifle. So, you know, because then when you're just doing the magazine dumps, that's not much of the feedback other than that the rifle is cycling. But here so far, I can tell you that the rifle is very accurate. Obviously will be accurate, you can tell that. Very soft recoil so far. The only thing what is worrying me is that rather shaky the ejection pattern. That's what I noticed, especially at the 100 meters distance. Sometimes, right now I don't see shells here, so it looks like it kicked them out a little bit better. Maybe it was just because it was brand new gun out of the box. We'll see how this is going to trend. But that's it, that's a green light for advancing to the 5,000 rounds. It was the special episode, a little bit behind the scenes of the AK Operators Union with the VSKA rifle from Century Arms. Stay tuned for the series, guys.